Welcome back to our channel. Today we will see about metallography sample preparations. This will be very helpful to the metallurgy students. Thing is, you can easily understand what are the steps, how to identify the microstructures after the process like welding, casting or forming, or after heat treatment. So let us go to the slides. Stick with me and learn the process. Not only for B.TECH laboratory, if you are going for research, this thing will be very helpful to examine your samples. There are five steps are available in metallography sample preparations. First one is cutting a specimen. So at which part you want to study, you have to cut the specimen. Later you have to go for mounting, depending upon the machine or examination where you going to have it. You should choose what type of mounting you want. Then you have to go for grinding using grinding papers. Finally going for polishing. After that all the hard works are over. Then we have to choose the suitable etchant to see the microstructures, right? Finally we will go for optical microscope equipment to reveal what type of microstructure is present over there, capture and later for analysis it. So first cutting a specimen, I have put here one welding schematic diagram. I have made one line during the midpoint line. We have to take the sample from this much area. Then you have to take it. For taking this sample, you may use water jet cutting, disc cuttings, or you can go for wire cutidium. Right. Do not engage your sample with plasma cutting or any other process, cutting process, which can raise the heat or temperature of the workspace. Thing is, if you are going with plasma cutting or any other cutting options other than I mentioned, temperature will be raised during cutting process. So that may be alter the microstructure. So the expected results may be deviated due to this heat, in extra heat input. So students, I request you to use wire cutidium if you have a metal samples or conducting materials. Other means you should go for water jet cutting, right? Abrasive wheel cutting I will never say, but you can go with disc cutting. It's also suitable for most of the aluminium and other specimens. If you have a titanium, inconel, etc., go for wire cutidium. So after cutting the specimen, we should go for mounting. I told depending upon the process you're going to do, you have to choose what type of mounting you want. Thing is, after metallography preparation, if you are going with SEM to deeply understand or deeply capture the microstructure and this thing, you should go with patlite powder mounting. No sir, I just want to do up to optical microscope, means you can go with cold mounting set. Okay, the first one is the packlite powders and is a hot mounting press. As name inside, we are going to have some temperature. During the temperature, that packlite powder will melt and they will bind together. Initially what you have to do, you have to take this out. Inside there is a small thing available, you can take it. You have to check what is your size, 1 inch, half inch, what is your size of sample. You have to take and you have to then you have to place your sample on the corresponding mold. After that you have to fill the mold with packlite powder. Then by using the hand press, you should lock it, then turn it, then switch on the cycles. There is an digital options are available, how much temperature you have to maintain, at how long we have to maintain those things. Okay, if necessary you can go with cooling water cycle. If you want, you can turn on the cooling water, it will carry out the excess heat. Later operation is over, your sample will be mount and it will be shown like this only. This is called hot mounting or packlite mounting. It is best suitable for SEM and other higher examinations. If you're going for micro harness, you can go with this because it will give clear cut flat surface, right? And another one is the cold mounting. These things are called cold mounting setup. This is a simple mold, rubber mold, where we are going to place the object first, then we have to pre-mix the resin with powder, mix it, pour it, then you have to put some weight. during that exothermic reaction, heat will be liberated. If you are not putting the load over it, it may buckle, specimen will not be in flat position, right? So it is where it is not advised to use this mounting for same as well as micro hardness examinations, right? So some of the samples that have more mounted with cold mount set. Grinding, so we should go with grinding after the mold. You are taking the specimen, like this specimen you have to take and you have to rub with the grinding papers. Simply you cannot use the grinding sheets as available in the market. For this we have fine numbers, as I told, 1200, 1500, 2000, up to it can vary. Specialized metallography grinding papers are available, you should use that one. Okay sir, after purchasing the grinding paper, how I can process it, whether fine to coarser or coarser to finer? No, first you should go with coarser, then at the end it should be with very very fine sheet, right? If you are not properly doing the grinding, scratches will appear when at last when you are putting the sample in the optical microscope, that time only it will appear. It's a headache. So after the grinding process, we should go for polishing, and this is called a disc polishing machine. Most of the metallurgy laboratory is using this one. This is an automatic one, right? So here two discs are available. Depending upon the process, you can vary the speed. If you want, you can use the waters. And here we are going to put the velvet cloth on it only. We have to put some aluminium powder mixed with water. You have to use to put it over there. Then you have to keep your sample on it. You have to make the sample as a stationary. The disc will rotate, so it will give a nice finish. At the end, you have to use diamond paste over the cloth. Then you have to keep your specimen steady as like as the previous case. As you can see, he is doing his polishing process by using cold mounting set. So etching is nothing but localized corrosion. So we need to take some metals or surface layer from that polished portion, so that only we can see the microstructure. Okay, there is a nominal time is needed. If it is too short, you can't see the microstructure properly. If it is high, there also you cannot identify what is the microstructure you have. So careful identification timing is needed. So how to do the etching? We need some acids. We cannot simply choose some acid for some materials. There is already and standard charts are available like this. Here I given some few materials and their etchant and etching time. Depending upon the temperature as well as your metal composition, this etching time will be vary, but the etchant should not be vary. You should take, at least if you are using carbon steel, you should go with this only, not the other etchant. If any alternate etchants are available, you should go for trial and error to fix the timing. After that only you will succeed, otherwise it is very difficult to identify the timing and the grain structure after the etching process. So there is four type of etching methods are available. There is one, you can dip the whole sample in the etchant, or you can do the swipe method, or you can go for immersion techniques, etc. There is one more electrolyte etching process also available, but I am focusing on the basic one, so not to worry about that one. So you have to check the ASTM metallography sample standard books and some researchers which is dealing with this type of material, so you will get an idea whether it's immersion type or dipping type or swap methods. So this is in small example I have taken from the research article, that copper specimen which is over etched and not exactly etched. This is a correct etching point, so you can see some grain boundaries and grains, and here there's a lot of hot spots are available, dark space are available, you are unable to identify what is the materials you have, it's showing some defects. So finally, after all the process over, you have to carefully place the sample on the optical microscope stand, and you can vary the magnifications according to your level. You can take the picture again, you can go for the further analysis. Thanks for watching. I heartily thank Muthupandi sir who trained me in the field of metallography sample preparations. I am also thank Arumugachami who is a technical assistant in NIT Trichy. I have a lot of experience. He only teaching me in the hands-on training while I entering the metallography sample preparation laboratory, and including my laboratory also, he only telling how to tackle the errors while preparing the metallography samples. I thank Arumugachami sir, who is in technical assistance. Once again, I'm telling, and other members also,